Ignition sequence starts. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Liftoff. We have a liftoff.
Hey everybody, this is the Digital Asset Investor, and I have gotten through almost the entire Stranger Things series, Season 3. For those of you that don't know, Stranger Things Season 3 came out on Netflix yesterday, so I spent a good portion of the day watching that, and I've got two episodes left. If you've never watched Stranger Things, you should start at Season 1. It's really worth watching. I wanted to start this video with this tweet from at Moon Overlord. He said, "The one thing I will say about alts is the upside on them right now is incredible." And he means altcoins, which means not all, but the good other digital assets besides Bitcoin. He says a lot of the top 100 altcoins are down 95 to 99%. They can't even go much lower. The upside is 10, 20, 50 times. What are you waiting for, that extra 0.12% down to buy them? Well, I think that some of these altcoins could go up even more than what this guy's saying. I've always believed that XRP has a 50-time upside at a minimum. I believe that it could be much more than that. But he's making a very good point here. And I'll make it again, since I've been in this, Bitcoin has always surged first, and then the altcoins kind of come afterwards. Well, Bitcoin has been surging, and now we're in a little bit of a pullback, and everybody's all like, "Oh, well, XRP hasn't done anything." Well, that is a positive as you sit here today. It's not a negative, because the potential of what's coming for XRP is so far greater than all of these clown coins, I'll call them, some of these altcoins that are just have no utility at all. Now, I also wanted to show you this. Yesterday, trading went live on BTR, which is BitTrue's new token that they've issued. And I put in a tweet yesterday that these, as we've learned from Binance and their BNB token, that thing came out at like 9 cents and has gone as high as $39 and something. And I think the point and the lesson to get out of that, and this doesn't go for all exchanges, I only say this where it has to do with good exchanges and exchanges that seem to be running their business in the right way. And I've said from day one, I thought that BitTrue was trying to model themselves after Binance, and they've also done some things that Binance should have done. They've added even more XRP pairs. Well, so when I saw that they were going to issue this BTR token, I saw that as a great opportunity. And so I have bought some of this, and I'll be buying more of it. Now, I'm not buying it because it went up 189% yesterday, which it did. It started, I think, at like 5 cents and went as high as 50 cents, but now it pulled back down to, you know, 15 or 16 cents, but went as high as 50% when it came out. I want to make one point about that. I'm not interested in buying when it's gone up 189%. I'd be buying that on the pullbacks, like I bought some this morning on that big pullback. But the main thing I want you to get out of this, though, is that these crypto exchanges have a built-in use case. They can do all kinds of things to give people incentives that are trading on their platforms to own these tokens. I think that, I can't remember if it was Binance or BitTrue, has one incentive where, I think it's Binance, where if you hold in your account a certain amount of BNB token, which is their token, then it gives you certain benefits on the platform. And so that is one of the many use cases that they can create all kinds of incentives for people to buy and hold their tokens. And for that reason, this is a good investment, in my opinion. Now, let's look at the market for a second. I'll do a refresh on this. This is from coinpaprika.com. I want to go back to this, and I'll keep going back to this Now we have $321 billion in the market, the highest we've been as this bull market has started. We've gone as high as into the $370 billion, and then we had a pullback. But I want to draw your attention. First, I'll show you the look how the Binance coin, you know, we were just talking about BTR. Look how this Binance coin, it's been one of the best performers. In fact, it's the third best performer in the top, no, except for Bitcoin. It's the fourth best performer. Bitcoin SV's the best performer, which blows my mind that that could even happen. But you got Bitcoin at 124%, and Ethereum's done well. But look at XRP, only up 7.36% in the quarter. I am continuing to load my bag. This is not even funny on this. That is the biggest joke in cryptocurrency that this hasn't happened yet. When it does happen, it's going to shock the freaking world, folks. Because when this one goes off, it is going to go off. And it's not just that one. It's Cardano. Cardano's down 13%, while some of these, like Litecoin, is up like that. That is crazy. So keep your eye on the ball, folks, because there's a lot of really big things that are going on with XRP that are not going on with any other digital asset. This is from Eric Dadoon. The sleeping giant of XRP and ILP ecosystems is busy building towards bank licenses and real utility. Beats even, ladies and gentlemen. Now, what he's tweeting out here is this is a tweet. This is a response from Beats even to a guy that right here, that this was a conversation on Twitter that was going on. Beats even needs to get a banking license so we can get a proper XRP derived bank. Working on that. Got an interesting meeting next week. Really looking forward to it. So VitaVin is literally working on a banking license so that we can literally have our own bank on our phone. How cool is that? An XRP bank. Okay, from Dan Rocky. I thought this was a really good tweet. I would not be surprised if the value of XRP is surging over the coming years due to micropayment utilization with Coil. What Ripple is doing is big. Actually, what Ripple is doing is massive. But forget Ripple for a moment. Coil could turn out to be even bigger. This use case will be in great demand. Now, he's tweeting this out. Says, let's start with the huge spike in sent XRP. Last month, we have learned that VitaVin and Coil implemented a new settlement mechanism for ILP payment. Last month, it was just 20,000 XRP. But this month, it was 900,000 XRP has been settled on the Coil and XRP Tipbot wallet. So you can see, now, for those of you that don't know, Coil is a way to monetize social media like blogs and YouTube videos, and so that when you go to people's blog or their YouTube page, that you're actually paying them in micropayments while you watch the video or while you read the blog. And then when you leave the site, it stops rolling and you stop paying them. This is the Coil model versus, say, if you want to read the Wall Street Journal online, you have to go and pay the Wall Street Journal $30 a month. This could change the world. That's the point they're making here. The use case here, if you can imagine that going across platforms, Imgur that Coil just partnered with. Imgur is a huge platform that they're going to put Coil on soon. Just another example. Okay. Next, this was a tweet from Michael Arrington. Now remember, he's Arrington XRP Capital. This guy knows the CEO of Binance. He knows the people at Ripple. He is connected. He tweets this out from Cointelegraph. Donald Trump says U.S. should match China's and Europe's currency manipulation. Is this a direct order to buy Bitcoin? Now, what I want to draw your attention to is this down here. Eric Vail Naylor, a.k.a. Mr. Cool Daddy, replies, and he says, if you have $12,000 available to either buy one BTC or 25,000 XRP, what do you choose? Michael Arrington says, today, BTC, but my opinion changes hourly. XRP is coming. It's just not clear when and what will happen to BTC in the meantime. But not being in BTC right now is extremely expensive. So I want to expound on that. I've told you many times, I have narrowed down my holdings to Bitcoin. XRP is by far my largest holding, and then Cardano. And then yesterday I added on some BTR just because of things I've already told you. Okay, that's it. Bitcoin and XRP are the biggest no-brainers of this whole game, folks. And so he's right. Bitcoin is something you should have at least some of, okay? And that's what I'm doing. But he's also right. XRP is coming. And when XRP comes and shows up to this appreciation party, get ready. Strap in. You're not going to even know what's going on because it's going to happen fast, and it's going to be what did the U.S. call it when we were in that we were in one of the wars? What did they call it? There was a term that they used for what it would look like. Shock and awe. That's what I think that XRP is going to be like when it takes off. Shock and awe. Okay, next. Now this is fascinating, folks. This, you can go watch this at NIKCANTMINE. Just going to leave this here. This is a video that you all need to see from a guy named Godfrey Bloom. He's a European politician. I think he was in the European Parliament. In this clip, and it's not a long clip, it's a 2 minute something clip. He pretty much summarizes for you the criminal Ponzi scheme enterprise that has been central banks of the world with all of their money printing and their QE and all of this. And he just does a tirade and lays it all out there for everyone to see. If you haven't seen this, you should go watch it. Go to @NickCantMine and watch this. He says, just going to leave this here. It's worth your time. And next, from Rhythm Trader, holding Bitcoin is the world's largest peaceful protest against financial surveillance, quantitative easing, elimination of cash, low interest rates, central planning, deficit spending, global tension, trade wars. It's about time the cartel was broken. Here, I agree. And next, this is a great tweet here from the Wolf of All Streets, Scott Melker. In the simplest terms, interest rates should rise in a strong economy and drop in a weak economy to help stimulate spending and growth. Donald Trump claims that the United States has the best economy ever, but also insists on lowering rates. The Fed, an independent agency, capitulates and announces that rates will likely drop. The stock market rages. Now we have strong economic data, 224,000 jobs in July, and the market drops because the Fed might not lower interest rates, which you would not do in a good economy. This is stupidity at its finest. Clearly, the only thing that matters to the market is the Fed. Everything else has become noise, even essential economic data. Stranger Things is back. We are living in the upside down. And he is so right. What our governments have done is the upside down. It is one flew over the cuckoo's nest. And digital assets will answer them, and it will be proportional. When all of this Ponzi scheme collapses under its own weight, and it will collapse, when it does, you will be thankful that you were here listening to the Digital Asset Investor, because the chickens will come home to roost. Believe you me. Now, this all ties together, folks. XRP Pyjama at Daniel V. Brett. Goodbye, dollar. It is nice knowing you. From Zero Hedge. I don't ever pull up their website because it weighs my computer down, but I am going to read you this clip, and I'll finish with this. At the recently concluded G20 meeting in Tokyo, Britain, France, and Germany announced that the special trade mechanism that they have been working on this year is now up and running. It is called the Instrument in Support of Trade Exchanges, INSTEX. And it will permit companies in Europe to do business with countries like Iran, avoiding American sanctions by trading outside the Swiss system, which is dollar denominated and de facto controlled by the U.S. Treasury. The significance of the European move cannot be understated. It is the first major step in moving away from the dominance of the dollar as the world's trading and reserve currency. Folks, for those of you in the United States listening to my voice, heed these words. Because you have no idea how much your standard of living has been enhanced over the last however many years, 50 or however long we've had the, I don't know what that number is, how long we've had the been the world reserve currency. But your standard of living is directly because of that. And the second, the U.S. has been irresponsible with that power. And now all of these countries don't want the U.S. to have that power. When the United States loses its status as the world reserve currency, your standard of living is going to be destroyed. There will be literally new classes of poor created in the United States as a result of this. This is part of this entire shift. And digital assets are the life rafts, okay? They're the life rafts. I'm the digital asset investor. I'm not an investment advisor. This is for entertainment purposes only. Please subscribe and hit the like button. And tell your friends and family that the U.S. dollar is the reserve currency. Yes, it is. It's a ticking time bomb that could go off at any time. Thanks for listening.